Hello and welcome to Unkie Gaming. This is Unkiejay here. Today I'm taking a look at Neverwinter, which is a new MMORPG by Cryptic Studios. You might know Cryptic Studios, they do Star Trek Online, and they also done City of Heroes, which closed down last year. So now this is their new project, Neverwinter. It's based on the Dungeons & Dragons tabletop. I'm going to be honest, I've never actually played Dungeons & Dragons at all, so I don't know the whole mythos and the lore behind all that. But Sarah knows it, and she'll be jumping in some of the videos. But for this video, I'm just going to show you a bit of the character customization. As you can see at the top, race selection, class selection, ability scores, appearance, background, and overview. So these are the classes you start with. You can get a half-orc, human, dwarf, elf, half-elf, tiefling, a halfling, and for the founders, you also get the drow. This is a race that you can't get in any other. You can't get it unless you got the Founders Pack, which is, I think, it's available. But the game comes out on the 20th of June, so I don't know if you can still purchase it after then. I'm recording this on the 19th of June, so the game is probably out by the time this video comes out. So here's all the classes. There's also female, of course. And as you can see, the graphics in this game are pretty good. So for this one, I think I'll pick a drow, seeing as it's the class that only founder can get at the moment. There's also another class coming soon. Another race coming soon. I don't exactly know what that is. Okay. So here are the classes. Trickster Rogue, which is your traditional rogue in games. It has Stealth, which I don't think you get to like level 10. Bend switch, jump backwards, dropping a decoy in your place. It's an encounter spell. Your daily spells, it sounds like you only get it once a day. You don't. You build it every time you attack, you build up a attack point meter, and when that gets to the filled up, then you can use your daily. So you can use it all the like heaps. And thievery, around the world there are little items that are class specific, so there'll be a little knapsack for a thief and they can open it, or someone with a thieving kit can open it. Every class has one. I think Devoted Clerk has religion and they can pray at certain things. Control Wizard has the Arcana one. Great Weapon Fighter and Guardian Fighter, I'm pretty sure both have Dungeoneering. Okay, so this is Devoted Cleric. Astral Charge toggles between the enemy and ally version if you right click. This class I've played a bit of actually. It actually changes around level 10, the class completely changes. You can build up attack power with a different attack. You've got a whole tab. It was totally different. It's the only healing class in the game at the moment. As you can see, it's coming soon, a new class. We don't know what that is yet. People are saying Paladin. Control Wizard, this is the class I've actually been using. I've been having a lot of fun. I've played the Great Weapon Fighter and the Devoted Cleric and a little bit of Guardian Fighter. So far, the Control Wizard is so much fun. I heard the Trickster Rogue is really fun. I've done a bit of PvP in the Trickster Rogue and Control Wizard seemed to really own it. Our Control Wizard does Arcane, Fire and Ice Magic. This is the attack you start off with, so that's your main attack at the beginning. Chill Strike is your encounter attack. Arcane Singularity, which is OP and looks amazing. It's your daily, it puts a big black hole and everything gets sucked into it. Great Weapon Fighter, who you would expect has a great weapon. They can sprint, they charge forward, they leap into the air and come down with a crushing force. And this is the only tanking class in the game, the Guardian Fighter. He has Guard, Taunt, and this temporarily heals a large portion of your health, with the damage you deal. So let's take a look at this. What class should I be? I think I'll pick a Great Weapon Fighter. No, maybe I'll pick a Trickster Rogue. Okay, so I've been told this is like what you do in the tabletop game. You have your stats here, strength, dexterity and charisma are my main stats as a trickster rogue. Sorry. Charisma, dexterity, and strength, yep. And you have a racial bonus, you get to choose one, so you can either get plus 2 dex, plus 2 wisdom, or plus 2 dex, plus 2 charisma. I think I'll just go 2 dex, 2 charisma. So you can reroll your stats to as much as you like. You can just keep rerolling until you get something you really like. I'm gonna try and get, 20 dex. That's good enough for me, I think. Next. Okay, so this is to facial appearance. These are the presets. Now, the drow are really dark people. If you know the lore, you'll understand why. Sarah gave me a bit of an introduction on it. And, seemed really in-depth. So these are the presets. I'm just going to do customize. Here is all the hair. There's so much hair to choose from. If you like sliders, you'll love the customization of this. Just look at all that. Here we go. We'll take a look at some of the hairstyles. There we go. The short hair, long hair, no hair. Because there's usually a lot of colors for hairs, but because I'm drow, there's only three colors, kind of. Like brown, dark brown, and white. Okay, let's do... Which hair should I get? No, we'll just pick on... That's the elfy looking hair. I'm gonna try to tame. We'll get the dreads, why not? Gold dreads. And eyes, you can make yourself blind. You can have red eyes. I think I'll just go with the red eyes. Why not? Eyebrows. Bushy because I'm a scary man. Facial hair. No facial hair on the male members of the drow. And you can choose how old you want to look. I am gonna go elderly. I'm not gonna go elderly. Tattoos! There's so many tattoos you can choose from. This is usually like the color of your hair that you can do as well. Let's just do this. As you can see, there's so many tattoos. You can create backstories for all of them if you so wish. Or you can just put dirt on your face like Skyrim characters. Scars! Everyone needs scars, right? The eye one's usually my favorite. Face scaling! So, you make your head gigantic or just average, I guess. Make your head wide or normal. Make your eyes gigantic or little. So there's a lot. I'm not gonna go through it all. It's making like that. Draw heavy. Draw slim. Tone. We'll just do tone. Big shoulders. With the female characters, there is actually a boob slider, which I found amusing. If you know anything that I do, every time I play MMO, I always make a girl character. And I try to make her have the biggest boobs ever. So this worked well for me. Making fat or skinny, legs, bulk, arm bulk, thickness of hands, there's everything. And you can also hide the armor if that's what you want to look at. Okay, so this is the character origins of your person that you're creating, so you can save from any one of these places all over this land. And then once you're there, you can pick a backstory. So this one in arm, everything has a price controlled by 5 wealthy and powerful merchant houses. And then you can be Blazing Star Recruit. You're part of a Blazing Star adventuring company, seeking fortune and glory. Or you could be a vigilante. You witness firsthand the corruption and immorality. Becoming a vigilante, seeking to punish the wicked. Or you could be a hunter of monsters. You have become skilled in hunting monsters in wild places and are at home in your more uncivilized environments. So each place has multiple storylines. And they're all different. No place has the exact same thing. Which I found really interesting. So if you want to roleplay, just like normal D&D, it's encouraged. So there's a lot. I'm going to say I'm from the North Dark, and I'm an exile. You violated the laws of the people of Nordark, and you've been banished from the surface. Okay, and you can also pick your deity affiliation. So this is the god you pray to. You can read all the stories there. I'm pretty sure it'd be the same in the D&D tabletop. Once again, I wouldn't know. Tempest is the god in battle and patron of martial model prowess. No, that's not me. God of lore, no, it's not me. I want, like, the dodgy one. We'll just go with this one. And when you start in game, you get a title straight away. You get two. You get one from the land you're from, and one from your deity affiliation. There we go, there's my character done. Class, race, ability, stats, city I'm from, deity, and then you can type in whatever you want there for your biography that everyone can see. So they just inspect you and they can read all that. So for this character, you can have spaces in your names. So you can be like Lord blah blah. I don't know, people do the weirdest names. Like I've seen, I think Frodo Swaggins. Yeah. So I'm just gonna be called Unkiejay, that's it. Begin adventure! So that was a quick look at the character customization in Neverwinter. I'll go more, there'll be more videos coming out, getting more into the game and what it's like. That'll be in other videos. Anyway, this has been Unkiejay from unkiegaming.com. Thanks for watching. If you do want to see more Neverwinter footage, just like the video and let us know what you want to see and I'll try and get to it. This has been Unkiejay. I'll see you next time. Bye! We'll be right back.